Hello students, so children, in the previous video we saw that how various European firms they turned up to India for trading, had great fight amongst themselves, and at the end ultimately the one which was victorious was the English East India Company. And children, I also familiarized you with one of the Mughal ruler who was Aurangzeb. And we studied that after his death, the Mughal Empire was disintegrated, was broken down into numerous independent kingdoms. So children, this breakdown of the Mughal Empire was taken as an opportunity by the English East India Company. They took an advantage of this disintegration and started establishing their territorial rule in India. And amongst all the provinces, children, Bengal was one of the richest provinces of the Indian subcontinent. And this is the reason why the English East India Company, they set up their first English factory on the banks of River Hooghly in 1651. Now children, this was the base, this was the main region from where the English East India Company, they traded, they operated their entire trade. The factory also had their warehouse near the factory. And children, as the trade of the company expanded, they started persuading, they started motivating their traders and merchants to come and settle down near the factory. So now if the traders and the merchants, they need to live near the factory, so they require some land, they require some houses to live. So children, 2 years later, the company, they started giving money to the Mughal officials, that they gave money to the Mughal officials for providing them the zamindari rights, to provide them the zamindari of three villages. And one of those three villages was Calicutta, present day Kolkata. And one thing more children, the company, they also persuaded the Mughal emperors to issue a farman, to give a royal order which granted the company the right to trade duty free. That means they gave them right to trade without paying any taxes. And the company, they continuously keep on trying, they continuously keep on persuading the Mughal emperors to provide them with more and more privileges, concessions and freedom, so that they can expand their trade to highest points in India and earn maximum profits. But children, like these grants were given only to the British companies, the other local rulers, the other private traders, they also started taking advantage of this. The Britishers, they did not pay the taxes because Farman was there. The other private traders, they also started not paying the taxes, due to which the Bengal, it had to face a huge amount of loss of revenue, because taxes hi nahi aa rahe the, and taxes are the main source of revenue for an empire, you all know that. So jab taxes hi aane band ho gaye the, the revenue, it declined, and it was a condition of huge losses for the country of, for the province of Bengal. So children, when the last powerful Nawab of Bengal, Aniwardi Khan, he was succeeded by his grandson Sirajuddullah, so he was very depressed by such decreasing revenues of the country. So what he did, he asked the Britishers to immediately stop working as per the farman and start paying the revenue. He cancelled the farman and he demanded Britishers to pay the revenue. He refused, he denied to give any kind of concessions, any kind of privileges to the East India Company, which they have been demanding from the previous years. He said that no privileges, no concessions will be given to you, as Bengal itself is going into losses. But now, since the Britishers, they were not agree upon it, so Sirajuddullah, he marched with an army of 30,000 soldiers against the Britishers. He captured the company officials, he disarmed his soldiers and got the monopoly, he got the rights over the Bengal back by completely denying every privilege to the Britishers. So children, now the Britishers, they retaliated, they fought against and they captured the areas of Calcutta, which is present day Kolkata, under the leadership of Robert Clive. Robert Clive was earlier in the Madras Presidency, but from there they sent him to recapture Calcutta. The Robert Clive, he conspired with Mir Zafar. Now, who was Mir Zafar? He was the chief, the commander-in-chief of Sirajuddin. So, they conspired, they made an agreement with him that they are going to help him to take over Calcutta. And English East India Company also managed to get the important members of Sirajuddin in their favor. Some amongst them were the Jagat Seth, who was his banker, Omi Chand, he was a very rich merchant, and the commander-in-chief Mir Zafar was already in the favor of Britishers. So with the help of their support, the British forces, they defeated the Nawab, they defeated Sirajuddin in the Battle of Plassey in 1757. And this Battle of Plassey, children, is very important in the Indian history. The reason is because this was the very first victory. It was the major victory of the company in India. It was the beginning. It was the beginning point from where the Britishers, they started ruling in the country. It was the first victory over India of the Britishers. Now, there were various results of the Battle of Plassey. Let's see what were they. The first one, Sirajuddin was captured and he was killed. Secondly, as the company has promised Mir Zafar ki if they won, they will make him the Nawab of Bengal. So they completed their promise. They made Mir Zafar the puppet Nawab of Bengal. Why puppet Nawab? Because he was completely a puppet in the hands of Britishers. He used to do whatever the Britishers told him to do. He granted 24 districts of Bengal to the Britishers, due to which they got a lot of financial help, because Bengal was a very rich province. So they got very financially stable. Unhe bahut zyada financial help mili in the terms of money, which made them stable in the country. Later on, with this victory, the English East India Company, they become the monopoly. They got their monopoly over the trade, kyunki wahan pe aur koi bhi European country aakar trade nahi kar sakti thi. Now the company, since Mir Zafar was a puppet in their hand, they had zamindari of 24 districts. Now, as you all know, children, if somebody is giving you benefits, so it is human nature ki if we get a small portion, toh will demand for more. Ye hamara human nature hai ki hamari agar ek demand puri ho jati hai, toh a new demand rises. So same was with the company. कि सिंस दे वर गेटिंग सो मच मनी, दे वर गेटिंग सो मच फाइनेंशियल हेल्प, तो डे बाय डे देयर डिमांड्स इन मॉनेटरी टर्म्स वाज इंक्रीजिंग. एंड द कंपनी, दे कंटिन्यूड टू मेक हैवी मॉनेटरी डिमांड्स, विच नाउ द नवाब, द मिर जफर, वाज अनेबल टू मीट. और जब मिर जफर ने कंपनी की हेल्प करनी बंद कर दी, तो कंपनी ने क्या करा, दे डिपोज्ड हिम, दे टुक हिज थ्रोन बैक, एंड इन हिज प्लेस दे इंस्टॉल्ड हिज सन इन लॉ, हुज नेम वाज मिर काजिम. मिर जफर को थ्रोन दिया था क्योंकि उसने सिराजुद्दीन को डिफीट करने में हेल्प की थी, मेड हिम दी नवाब. जब तक वो उनकी रिक्वायरमेंट्स पूरी कर रहा था, ही वॉज दी नवाब ऑफ बंगाल. एज सून एज ही स्टार्टेड रिफ्यूजिंग, एज सून एज ही वॉज अनेबल टू फुलफिल द डिमांड्स ऑफ द कंपनी टुक हिम ऑफ द थ्रोन एंड हैंडेड ओवर द थ्रोन टू हिज सन इन लॉ, हुज नेम वॉज मिर काजिम. नाउ सिंस मिर काजिम बिकेम द न्यू नवाब ऑफ बंगाल, but later, after a few days only, soon he realized that he was dependent upon English East India Company for everything. So he wanted to consolidate the power, he wanted to has his own power, and he started making efforts for that. What did he did? He dismissed all of the Mir Zafar's officials, whoever officers were appointed by Mir Zafar, he removed all of them. He invited European mercenaries to train his soldiers in the new methods of warfare as the English East India Company used to do. Then the biggest step what he took was he abolished all the taxes on the internal trade. अब ब्रिटिशर्स को स्टार्टिंग में क्या प्रिविलेज मिलता था बंगाल से, कि उन्हें कोई भी टैक्स पे नहीं करना पड़ता था, ट्रेड के लिए कोई भी टैक्स पे नहीं करना पड़ता था. बट अब मिर काजिम ने क्या करा, ही अबॉलिश्ड ऑल द टैक्सेस फ्रॉम द इंटरनल ट्रेड. अब जब टैक्सेस इंटरनल ट्रेड से भी हट गए, तो इट गेव एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंडियन ट्रेडर्स टू ट्रेड. नाउ दिस थिंग वॉज नॉट लाइक बाई द ब्रिटिशर्स, कि जो प्रिविलेज हमारे हैं वो सिर्फ हमारे तक ही रहने चाहिए. वाई इट इज़ बीन गिवन टू द इंडियंस. एंड on the other hand, Mir Kazim also started checking the misuse of privileges what the Britishers were doing. नाउ सिंस मीर काजिम वॉज वर्किंग अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स, ब्रिटिशर्स ने उसे थ्रोन दिया था, बट ही वॉज मेकिंग प्लान ऑन द अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स ओनली. सो ब्रिटिशर्स वर वेरी सरप्राइज टू दीज मूव्स एंड देयर फॉर दे डिसाइडेड टू गेट रिड ऑफ मीर काजिम. सो नाउ दे इंडल्ज्ड इन टू अ बैटल. वॉट डिड द मीर काजिम डिड? ही फॉर्म्ड एन अलाइंस, ही फॉर्म्ड अ ग्रुप with the Nawab of Awadh, Suhajudullah, and Shah Alam, who was a Mughal emperor, for expelling the Britishers from Bengal. They all combined armies, they indulged into a revolt with the Britishers, and that revolt was known as Battle of Buxar because it was fought at Buxar. But ultimately, is battle mein bhi kya hua? The Britishers, they defeated all the three combined armies and became the real master of Bengal. Mir Kazim was expelled from Bengal, aur Mir Zafar, jise pehle Britishers ne hataya tha, usse wapis kya kiya gaya? Wahan ka Nawab banaya gaya. Now, the Nawab of Awadh, who was Nawab of Awadh? Just now I told you. Yes, Suhajudullah, what did he did? He wanted his kingdom back. So what agreement he had with East India Company, that he is going to pay a war compensation, wo war indemnity pay karega company ko. What was it? It was 50 lakh rupees. इसके एक्सचेंज में उसे उसका किंगडम क्या किया जाएगा, उसका किंगडम उसे वापस दे दिया जाएगा. Then children, now the Diwani allowed the company to use the revenue resources. Now again the rule was in the hand of Britishers, तो वो फिर से बंगाल के resources use कर सकते थे to purchase cotton and silk textiles, maintain company armies and meet the cost of building. So now the Battle of Buxar clearly displayed that the military, the English persons, the Britishers has a superior military power than the Indians. जो Britishers की army है वो इंडियन आर्मी से बहुत ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्ग है. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, इन 1764 द ब्रिटिशर्स दे मेड रॉबर्ट क्लाइव एज द नवाब ऑफ बंगाल, एंड बीइंग द नवाब ओवर देयर, रॉबर्ट क्लाइव ही इंट्रोड्यूस्ड अ न्यू सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट विच वॉज न्यून एज ड्यूल गवर्नमेंट और डायरकी इन बंगाल. नाउ वॉट इज इट? ड्यूल गवर्नमेंट. सो यू ऑल नो ड्यूल का क्या मतलब होता है. ड्यूल मीन्स टू and government means the ruling power. So now what does dual government? अब एक state के अंदर दो government कैसे हो सकती हैं? So here let's see what was dual system of government. Under this system there were two heads, one was the Nawab and other was the company. The Nawabs had powers of military and criminal jurisdiction, while the company has exercised control over revenue. Company के पास क्या power थी कि state का जितना भी पैसा आएगा, जितना भी revenue होगा, वो सब किसके पास जाएगा? Company के पास. और उसके अलावा जो भी state के matters होंगे, like whatever apart from money, चाहे वो criminal matters हैं, चाहे वो military matters हैं, either it is building, it is people's problems, everything was with the Nawab. So now this was a problem, क्योंकि the company, they had all the power, उनके पास सारी power थी, but they did not had any responsibility. ना उनके ऊपर military की responsibility थी, ना लोगों की responsibility थी, ना criminals की responsibility थी, but they had power over revenue, they had all the powers. And on the other hand, जो Nawab था, he had all the responsibilities, but he had no administrative power, he does not have resources. Resources here means money. So now Bengal suffered a lot due to this system, and finally in 1772 children, the Warren Hastings, he ended the dual system of government and he brought Bengal under the direct control of company's administration. Now the company had complete control over Bengal in the terms of money as well as in the term of responsibilities. The rule of Nawabs came to an end.